Now we're coming up on the Waterfall Glenn here, which surrounds the Argonne National Lab. I usually just call it Argonne for short. See ya. That's the little parking lot back in there, and that's the driveway into the lab. It's a nice little drive in here. As we come up here, we can kind of see into the lab's property over there. Let's see as we kind of circle around. That windmill is new. I wasn't there before. There's some more of it back there. All right, this is the end of Cass Avenue right here. And I usually, well, I often park right in this little gravel here, like right where that car is parked. There's a little trail looks flooded right now though. It's all wet and mushy in there, so I don't want to go this way. So you can see we're going up on a little bit higher ground here. This is the entrance to the parking lot, like if you're gonna go to the youth camp and the you know, the main parking lot, there's the residence there for the, what do you call him, the park ranger. I'm gonna park up here though, and then what we're gonna do is we're gonna hike back through the woods to that parking lot. So we're here now. I'm going to grab my gear and we're going to hike right through. There's the start of our trail. From there we'll go down to the waterfall and wander around and figure out what we're going to want to try and do, like 8 miles today, maybe seven, you know, depending on how I feel. It's still fairly early, so I think we should get a lot of hiking in. What do we have here? We have the Woodland Habitat Improvement Project, which that basically consists of them lighting everything on fire and burning it. That's about all they did. I'm gonna head down this way. It's nice to see this is starting to dry up in here. Last time I came through here, it was fucked. Someone's made a little bridge.
Look at the, this is Signal Hill here. That's what this area is called. We're on the north side of the hill. It's train tracks. You guys can see the train tracks. There's a train running on the other side there. That's kinda sorta, I don't even frickin' know. That is I want to say roughly east and west traveling. But here, as you can see, the hill kind of drops down and it opens up into this cool little area. This goes on, this here goes on quite a ways, and it goes around a bend and some other areas until we eventually get back to the parking lot. So I'm going to turn the camera off now. I don't think you guys want me to see the... I don't think you guys want to see me do the entire frickin' hike. Looks like sap is coming out of this wound here. Might be a little source of fat wood for me later down the road. Of course, I don't have my knife with me tonight, or today, so we're not gonna do anything with it, but I'm definitely gonna remember where I'm at. I'm over here in this muckety-muck section. We're in the woods behind the youth camp now. It's a little bit of a path here. This path completely disappears in the summer when all this grows over and you have to fight your way through it. This takes a spark. All right, looks like we're coming up on the youth camp. It should be empty because it's a Friday morning. I don't think they do anything here till the weekend. We'll take a look at that. There's a main path right here that leads back to the parking lot. So we're not even really in the woods yet. We're kind of taking the scenic route. Go check this out over here. Oh crap, I just inhaled one of the little bugs. Let's see what the sign says. Looks like Troop 374 has this today and tomorrow. Obviously, they're not here yet. School gets out, what, 3 o'clock? They're probably set up this evening. Here's the, here's a map where we're at. This is the, that's a nice map. How come my map doesn't show that? That's the, here's the path we just came up on. That's this path right here. So, we're going to follow that path back to the parking lot and come down here to the waterfall. And then we're going to get off the main trails and go down all the little foot, one of the little footpaths that goes along this trail here. Meet back up with it here and then cut inside this area here is where I like to roam. Where no people are. So if they recently redid all this roofing up here, and it used to be, this board here used to be half the size and you could fit your fingers up in it, so I would do pull-ups off of that. But I would do pull-ups off of that when it was smaller, you know. But I can't really fit my fingers in there anymore to do them, especially now with the injury now. But I'll have to come up with something. I've been through some amazing storms while I was out training underneath this thing. I mean, God, hail and trees blowing over sideways and shit. It's all kinds of crazy stuff. Let's see what we have here. Looks like we've got, looks like two scout groups are using this weekend. So what they'll do is they'll, this whole area out here, they'll fill that up with all their tents and stuff, and then they drive their Boy Scout truck up to here and they park them in this little spot here. So we're gonna follow this path back to the parking lot. I'll show you the main board and where the pump, the well is. The well is not to be confused with the natural flowing spring well that's in here somewhere too. I'll show it on the other map, but it's pretty far in there. And you got a map and compass it because there's no way to it anymore. In another month, you won't be able to walk here. Where the fuck is the phone? There it is. We could fill up our canteen here. It's a perfectly working pump. That's what everybody does, but I'm gonna go get my water out of the creek today. What do we have here? This shows the splattered little pieces of woods that we do have around here. That's not what I want. Put that back. Anything else? Yeah, no maps today. Guess I'll have to use the old one that I already have. Anyway, this is the big board. Our little information board here. Back on some of these bigger trails. These are for the suburbanites and their families and all that to go down to the waterfall. Yeah, that's the waterfall we gotta get to down there. Doesn't look like there's a whole heck of a lot of people there. I see maybe one person sitting on the edge. This is the area that they built. There's all kinds of erosion, this whole, like, half circle thing was slowly collapsing into the stream and pushing the stream over, so they dug it all up and backhoed it or whatever they did, and they made this nice little thing here. That path used to just be rough mud and muck, and there was a tree that had fallen over, you had to climb over. It's all gone now. It looks really nice and everything, but I kind of miss the challenge of the way it used to be when it was all wild still, you know? This is the shot I'm looking for. Ah, that's absolutely gorgeous. I mean, nothing's even grown out yet. It's still all brown. On a weekend, it's packed full of Skittles people down there. I'll get down over in there somewhere and I'll take a shot from the bottom up too. Alright, so we're gonna go around this way and down the little stairs next. There's the little steps. Let's come down the hill here. Here's There's a turtle that lives in here somewhere. We see him every year, and every year he's fatter than he was the year before. Somehow all the little kids in here haven't managed to catch him yet, or if they have, they throw him back. When it's really hot, everybody splashes around in there. Lots of little garter snakes and stuff, or garden snakes, hide up inside those rocks, and the little kids catch them and play with them, and then they throw them back in the water. Yeah, in the middle of the morning on a Friday, it's pretty dead. There's like nobody here. Yeah, there's one little, looks like a little kid over there. Wandering loose in the woods. Oh, there's a parent. Following up behind in her cell phone, ignoring the beauty. But, normally this is packed and there might be 25 to 50 people here on a Saturday or Sunday, especially if it's warm out. So I like to get out here on a weekday morning if I can. And just sit. Now we're coming up to the end of the little foot trail, and there's a little ramp as I like to sit by. It looks like someone's already over there. So I'm gonna give this guy his peace and quiet. He's having a sandwich. I'm gonna head over to the other spot. See how the trails are starting to get smaller, and we're still in the relatively populated part of it too. We haven't even gotten close to getting to the back areas. Haven't even been here yet this year. I mean, this might be freaking washed out for all I know. Oh, there we go. I love these little trails. And here we go, this little gravel bar or sandbar, whatever the hell you want to call it. I do a lot of kung fu right here too, because it's, you know, it's just long enough to do some of my smaller forms. I can do all my qigongs and stance training and freaking everything here. You know, it gives me a nice spot to work, have some peace and quiet. I've got the sun in my eyes here, though. I gotta have that for the back of the camera. Hopefully this guy up here will be gone, because I'm really thirsty and I want to get some water. All right, I'm dying of thirst, and it looks like I found a great spot to get some water. Let's come over here. All this fast-moving water, they tell me, is supposed to be safe to drink. Something about the oxygenation of the water killed the cryptosporidium or whatever. I see it's a little silty, probably because it's moving so fast. So let me set the camera up here, and I'll find a good spot to get to fill my canteen. This is where I think I'm going to cross to go back the other side here. Look at that.
Alright guys, I think at this point I'm going to call it quits and, for this video and, maybe do a part two. For right now we're maybe 2 miles into the hike. I've just hit my favorite spot that I always hit. This is where I generally start my hike from. So everything up until this point is just getting to the start of it. And I think in the next video I'll continue on and show you the rest.